for now.
For me, wasted potential is worse than something that's just dead on arrival. Like, because then you don't have to care. And like, I don't want this game to be bad. I don't want to play a bad game. I want to play a good game. I want to play a game that's fun and I enjoy playing and it enriches my life. And I'm like, yeah, I'm having a good time. I don't want to play a bad game. I don't want to hate this game. I want it to be good. So when there's like those tiny little moments of shining through the darkness, being like, look, this could have been something. It just makes me go like, God, Leon was right about damn it. Like when the shit starts piling up, it's even worse. Because of those moments of, fuck, it could have been something else. It could have been good. It could have been good. It could have been a good game. But it's just so miserable. Like, I just feel so bad playing this game. It's like anti-fun.
Ah, Agent Birkin, impeccable timing. Kindly take these two into custody, won't you?
They said you were involved in the terrorist attack. Is it true?
What? Are they running down the street screaming it to anyone who'll listen?
Answer me!
Apparently.
It's for the benefit of the United States and global security.
Oh my God, he didn't even try to deny it.
We have Leon to thank for that.
God damn you, Simmons!
Dispose of them.
He didn't even try to deny it! Hey, Sherry, maybe you should get behind the fuck. Who are these stormtroopers?
Those two are still of use to us.
Are you fucking kidding me? This is so bad.
Careful.
Alright, so what's the plan?
She was just standing around out in the fucking open while they were shooting.
Why don't we just waste him? Because I need you to take care of Sherry.
Oh my God, this is so bad!
There are better things to do.
What are you two gonna do?
Like, what is this fucking, like, third-rate James Bond garbage?
There's information on here that could stop the C-virus. Simmons wants it.
Thanks. I'll put a call into FOS, get you some protection.
I'm gonna tell you my evil plan! And tell you about how I'm... Okay, that's a cool moment. If you squint your eyes, you could almost mistake Helena for Claire.
Not a chance.
You promised.
I lied.
See, like, moments like that. That's what I'm talking about. Like, that was the stupidest thing ever with fucking Simmons. But... I promised, and then they do the cool thing. Like, come on. Like, oh look, they love each other. It's adorable. Is that it? That's terrible. That's a terrible ending to a fucking chapter. Are you kidding me? That's really bad. Okay. You see what I'm talking about? They're like fucking... I can breathe! I can breathe! Ah, fuck. Back down. Back down, like, immediately. Just fucking drown me to death. Just kill me. You know, just kill me. Like, if it's just bad all the way through, it's just prolonging the suffering to come up for air and be like, oh, brief respite. A fucking moment. Of reprieve. So we're almost done. Do you want to maybe just finish off Jake's chapter? Or... No, I like switching between them. Because we've seen Chris and Jake go through China. We haven't seen Leon in China yet. And all of their camp... Like, China's the level, apparently, where all their campaigns keep intersecting. So that's really cool. So let's go with this. It has... What was the last thing? I think, like, they faked their deaths or something stupid like that. Ah, there was a fucking loading screen about the amateur mode. Hold on. I want to see what that shit said. Oh, look, on the TV. That's the camera that, like, tried to interview Chris, and Chris knocked the camera out of the way. See, like, moments like that, those are pretty nifty, right?
How you holding up?
I don't know, just small details like that.
You could have cleared your name.
Maybe, but it wouldn't have stopped Simmons. Besides, you're starting to grow me a little bit.
Not me. I hate this cunt. Fuck her. Light her on fire. Fuck this bitch. I hate her. She's terrible. Worst female character in Resident Evil. And there's some fucking bad ones. What kind of plane is this? I know I said they're all good, but I'm talking about, like, playable characters. All the playable female characters are really good. But, like, there's some really bad, like, NPC or, antagonistic female characters that are pretty terrible. I like Ashley. Ashley's pretty bad, for example.
Hit into the same kind of monster we saw back at the cathedral.
What?
Oh, hey.
Because...
Oh, fuck you! What is this? What plane in the fucking history of the universe fucking looks like this? Are you kidding me? What's that movie with, shit, what's his name?
Leon, Helena, do you read?
The guy from Taken.
There's something wrong with the pressure bulkhead. Get to the tail of the plane.
No! There's a fucking, a movie about, like, this chick and all her daughter's missing and you're on the plane and all what's going on. And it's like this double-decker plane and it's the most fucking retarded thing. I ride on planes all the time. I used to travel a lot by plane. Like, all over the country. Not all over the country, but I would fly to my grandma's house, and she lives out of state, so I would fly to visit my grandma, and I would go on, like, on vacations, like, to Washington, D.C. for school and whatnot. I would go on planes all the time. And I have never seen a plane in the history of the universe that looks like this. Like, is it supposed to be, like, a cargo liner? How did they get access to riding passenger on a plane like this if they're faking their deaths and they're wanted by the government agencies and whatnot? Like, this should just be a passenger liner, right? Why did Leon get rid of his jacket? I guess he was like, hey man, if something happens, I don't fucking want some asshole to take that jacket and wear it and just steal my jacket. At least this way, I'll know where the jacket is and I can come back for it later. Maybe that's how he felt.
I think we made it in time.
I do like how all the characters in Resident Evil have colors associated with them. Like, they all have a primary... Whatever, just kill it. I'm gonna kick you! I'm kicking you so good! You can't even handle how good I'm kicking you. Oh, look, I'm gonna kick you again! Yeah! Fuck you, just kill it. Whatever. It's stupid. Shut up, Helena. I hate you. I don't need to listen to you. I'm fucking Leon Scott Kennedy. I'm doing this because I want to. Oh, you're covering me so good, by the way. Why do I have so many of these? All the Resident Evil characters have a color scheme associated with them. Leon's is blue and black. Chris's is green. Jill has kind of like a teal light blue. Barry is red. Claire is very, very light red, almost pink, depending on the game. That was out of spite. Like, there was no reason for that. That was just Leon being a dick. Oh, look, are we playing Uncharted 2, you guys? Uncharted 3. That's it. Are we playing Uncharted 3, everybody? Look at this Uncharted 3 shit right here. Once again, Uncharted, a game that ripped from Resident Evil 4, a game that only exists because of the popularization of what Resident Evil 4 did. Now fucking Resident Evil is ripping off from its ripoffs.
Helena, we have to go.
Anyway, I always appreciate, like, good character design when it comes to, like... Oh, everyone's a zombie now. Yeah. Zombies are, like... You see, like, look. It doesn't even... just completely stun-locked. It's really bad. It doesn't work with this fucking control scheme. Like, they just don't react to being shot at all. Like the Ganados do. Like the Jim Jones. The Jim Jones are basically just Ganados, and they react to being shot in the same way that... Okay, why don't you guys turn into zombies? Why did these guys all instantly turn into zombies? But you guys, who were at Ground Zero fighting the thing, you guys don't turn into zombies. That's fucking stupid. I just always appreciate good character design when it comes to, like, instant recognizability. You can always tell a good character design by if you can recognize it from its silhouette alone. And I don't know, just part of that is, like, color association. To me, I think that's a really simple but nifty kind of deal you can do with character design.
This is why I can never sleep on planes.
Stop taking control of the camera away from me, thank you. And even newer characters like Sheva, her color is purple because she's black. But I like it. I think it's really nifty. You know what's I always love plane levels in games. What's the Mile High Club from Call of Duty Modern Warfare 1.
When you open the hatch, you destabilize the plane by letting the pressure out. Leon, you're gonna need to take the controls.
I was afraid you were gonna say that.
Levels like that are always just a lot of fun, because planes are this really fun setting you can do interesting stuff with.
First, switch off the autopilot to restore manual control. Then, press the third button in the fourth row of the upper panel. Okay, now pull the lever on the right-hand side.
Okay. This is harder than it looks. Come on. Pull up.
Because, like, it's got the tension of being, you know,
Leon, pull the throttle! Pull up!
How many levers does it take to fly this thing?
Shockingly a lot. You're doing a good job, computer. You're doing a good job. Everyone's really proud of you. Cause it's this environment that has a lot of potential variability to it, because you can have the plane twist and shake around and everything like that. And like, turn... Oh shit, Ada! And turn... Everyone's in China right now. And turn around upside down and do a lot of fun stuff. Okay, they're dead. Like, they're completely dead. Leon and Helena both did not survive. Like, you do not get more dead than that shit right there. Oh my gosh. But Leon might be fine, but Helena was standing up. That bitch is dead. Like, you will get your ass... Oh, fuck you. It doesn't even show how they got out! Oh, this is so stupid. Anyway, so we just saw this.
Sherry?
Still touches my little heart. My little heart. Detective detail. Makes me feel all fuzzy on the inside.
I heard you became an agent.
Why are you here?
I'm tracking the man behind all this. Chief Security Advisor Simmons.
There must be some sort of mistake.
Why are you here? The plane.
He's your supervisor?
The plane crashed.
We're on our way to meet with him right now.
Where is he? I need to know.
Jake!
Still really dumb. You know, we just saw this. I'm gonna go ahead and skip it. How do you skip? Okay, there you go.
Watch out for his arm!
Oh, goody! The same boss fight. We fought literally 3 seconds ago. I guess that's what happens. Oh, the quick time event, you guys. So bad! Anyway. Can I even get up there? What is the point of having those crates filled with ammo?
This guy's indestructible. Let's get the hell out of here.
Hey, that's actually new dialogue. I don't remember that being said last time. Right. Fuck this, I never use these anyway. Anyway, this game is bad because it's not fun and I don't like playing it. And it makes me nostalgic for the good Resident Evil games. I like how Leon just jumps it himself. That's really funny.
Are you okay?
Compared to Raccoon City, this is a walk in the park, right?
I don't know. We have to understand what happened back then. Come on.
Yeah, remember that time you got fucking raped by your dad, Sherry? That was fucked up. I bet you're really glad you were too young to realize how fucked up that was.
Sherry, get behind the wheel.
Oh my god. Oh, it was really bad. Oh, this isn't even a quick time anything. Oh yeah, it is.
Okay, let's move.
Roger!
Planes and boats, I find, are underutilized when it comes to horror settings. Okay. Yeah, that's
how
really nice.
Still standing?
In any kind of thing, I think, because those are boats especially, I think, make really good settings for horror games.
Like I said, indestructible.
Because A, the ocean is scary.
Afraid not. Doesn't mean we gotta make things easy for them.
Like, have you seen the ocean? It's really scary. And it's a, like, confined environment that you can't really escape from. Like, you can't really just get off a boat if it doesn't have, you know, lifeboats or anything like that. You're kind of just stuck there. Especially if it's like in the Atlantic Ocean. You can't just jump off and swim out. Like, that's really bad. You can't do that shit.
Until we get there, I need you to...
And, like, a really, really big, cruise liner. Or a cargo ship.
Finnegan?
Oh, you went dark after the plane went down. I linked in a minute ago, but you weren't picking me up. Listen, the building Agent Birkin mentioned isn't far off. Just stick to your current...
How did you hear that?
Got it.
Excuse me? You lost us after the plane crashed. I linked in a minute ago, but you weren't picking up. By the way, I heard everything that you were saying while I wasn't linked in and you weren't picked. Fuck this game. Oh, slow walking! Slow walking the video game! Slow walking! Okay. I hate that too, by the way. I can't run either for some reason. Oh, hey! This is the first time that Leon would be fighting the Jim Jones, isn't it?
Trouble.
That's interesting. If you had just been playing Leon's campaign from beginning to end, this would be your introduction to the Jim Jones after fighting nothing but zombies this whole time. That's really interesting. And look, a slow, low moment of not constant action, where you're just walking along in an empty environment, and it's attempting to build tension. It's failing.
The bolts on either side.
It's failing. It's not working, but I appreciate the effort at the very least. Look, it's an abandoned Chinese thing, and I'm tripping over
the
shit.
The bolts on either side. That.
And, it's introducing a new enemy to us, and all of these people are dead. It doesn't work, but
great.
I appreciate it.
Locks.
I appreciate the effort.
Alright, let's just figure out a way to open it.
Oh, fuck you. What? What?
Guess that's why the whole street is on lockdown. Residents are trying to keep it out.
What?
Well, this one is different.
It's stupid is what it is. Look at how goofy it is.
That's a new trick.
That's stupid. It's just the Slugman from Resident Evil Zero. Only terrible. Okay, and it's indestructible, and we gotta go find the keys. You know what would have been nice? Stop taking control of the game away from me. Oh, hey. You know what would be nice? If it didn't have the fucking pop-ups telling me where all the keys are. And I just had to... Oh, come on. Oh, yeah, those famous... Chinese, bizarre fucking bulletproof fish tanks. Bulletproof aquariums in the Chinese market. Gotta protect the fish. Gotta make it fucking, bulletproof. If it didn't tell me where the fucking keys were and I was just following a fucking pop-up waypoint on the fucking screen and instantly knew where they all were and instead, there's two now. Okay, I was like, what? Teleportation? Excuse me. And you actually had to navigate around this environment and actually, discover where the keys are independently and try and, figure it out on your own. Maybe that would be slightly interesting. I appreciate the effort. I appreciate the attempt. But again, the way that this game is, it just can't do it. Like, it's trying to throw classic Resident Evil conventions a bone, but it can't do both.
Okay, only one left.
It's trying to do both. I don't know, like, what's the best way to put it? I guess it feels like there's too many cooks in the kitchen. There's too many cooks will spoil the broth. Too many cooks. And none of them knew what the fuck they were doing! Like, one cook thought they were making a fucking filet mignon, and another cook thought that they were making, like, a seafood salad! It's terrible! Like, no one knows what the fuck's going on! Oh, I killed it. Well, that's stupid. Hurry up, computer that I have no control over.
Hold on, I'll open it. Come on!
And, like, I remember it being said somewhere that each scenario, each character campaign had a different, like, lead designer, not, like, a gameplay director. So, like, that's why they all feel differently, because an entirely different person was running the development of that chapter. And I appreciate the... Fucking really? I appreciate the having each character's campaign play differently. I do think that's really nifty.
You got it.
But it just doesn't come to. But even like within.
Get the hell out of here.
Each individual campaign, it feels schizophrenic. Like, you have Leon's campaign is the most schizophrenic, where it's trying to have those moments hearkening back to the classic games. But then it's also trying to have the high-octane set-piece action moments, too. And then you had Jake and Sherry, which have, like, grounded... sequences of combat, and then you have fucking all instant fail stealth moments with the fucking OODA check. And then you have the vehicle sections where, oh, we gotta ride the fucking motorcycle and escape the thing. Like, if it was three different campaigns, and it was three entirely different models of gameplay, that would be one thing, but all three campaigns are trying to do the same split of action and moments of levity and cinematic action sequences where you basically don't have control. Oh, it's Ada again.
Ada?
Let's follow her.
Had the little music cue of Lara Croft finding an item. I miss Ada's theme from Resident Evil 2. That shit was off the fucking hook. Look up Ada's theme from Resident Evil 2. It's probably one of the best pieces of music in the entire series. I honestly love it. How is she able to change shirts so fast? We saw her earlier on top of the train. She was on top of the train. We saw her while we were in the plane. And she had a red shirt on. All of a sudden now she's wearing a purple shirt. That's interesting. And now here's the... Now here's the same sequence as when we were fighting with fucking Chris. Or whatever. Oh, come on.
I don't have time for your game.
In the bedroom, am I right? Aw, this time they got the elevator. Who fucking cares? And again, this is another moment of convergence.
He got to it first.
Where the people playing as Pierce and Chris, you're actually like competing against them during this section. And that's actually kind of interesting, right? Like, it's trying to be everything. And it's being made by, and like, not only like, does that kind of inhibit its ability to just be the one thing. Like, it's better for something to be one thing really well than try and do multiple things and end up accomplishing it mediocre.
What is this room?
Slow walking the video game. Slow walking the video game. I sure do have a lot of machine pistol ammo. Slow walking, you guys.
Locked.
Engaging locks. Testing for prototypes.
So, like, not only are they splitting their design... between different kinds of gameplay.
Rigged with explosive charges. What the hell is she thinking?
I'll ask her once we catch her.
And that's taking resources away. You know, it's taking away resources from just making one type of gameplay really well. They're instead splitting so much focus and just making them all kind of shitty.
Run interference. I'll work with Hunnigan to override the security.
Security breach detected in room zero.
But security the game, like, it's also being made by a team that's kind of inexperienced with that security kind of gameplay.
Security breach detected in room zero.
This is a team that's used to making Resident Evil games in the fashion of what Shinji Mikami taught them how to make it, right? Of the classic games, and even Resident Evil 4, which was a departure, even given that, you know...
Someone doesn't want us to catch Ada. She might not be working alone.
It still wasn't an entirely different kind. It still controlled with tank controls. And it was still about resource management and enemy interaction. The difference between the classic games being about enemy avoidance, whereas Resident Evil 4 was all about different kinds of enemy interaction.
Not a talking move.
And you could shoot, like you had to set up, like you shoot them in the head. That was a way to set up for a melee attack that would like lead to splash damage, or shoot them in the leg so that they would fall over. Stop interrupting gameplay. Look at the way she's running like a fucking loser. That's so gay.
Don't lose her.
I won't.
Like, it wasn't a complete departure. Like, superficially, it seemed to be a departure. It seemed to be a completely different kind of game. But if you put them side by side, there's more similarities than there are differences. And the action-heavy moments, you know, of the big bombastic boss fights and fucking Commando, a knife fight with Krauser and stuff like that. Even those were relatively grounded. Like, it was ludicrous and goofy, but it felt grounded in a sense of familiarity. Like, it wasn't an entire world apart from what the series was.
Leon.
It wasn't this complete departure.
What are you doing here?
Ugh, my legs.
Put your gun down, Chris. She's a key witness. We need her.
A witness? She's the one who did all this!
No, it wasn't her. It was Simmons.
And then Resident Evil 5 was it was the same gameplay as RE4, but they had no idea what the fuck they were doing. Like, if you watch the Separate Ways playthrough of RE4 of that playthrough, the Separate Ways where you play as Ada, that is like the most RE5 that RE4 got. And aside from all the lazy asset reuse and whatnot, like watch Separate Ways, and that's sort of the same experience as RE5. Like, it's still the same game as RE4, but just shitty. They didn't know what the fuck they were doing. It didn't have that guidance of a skilled designer who really knew what the deal was. And it was just so action-heavy, set piece, like, fucking turret sections all over the place.
Chris, wait.
Like, linear, scripted whale shooter turret sequences. But, you know what I mean, it was still grounded. There was a natural progression of the series towards a more action-y, tongue-in-cheek leaning. But then this game is a complete and total departure. It doesn't play like the other Resident Evil games. It plays like a generic cookie-cutter third-person shooter, like Gears of War-style third-person shooter. And they don't know how to make that kind of game, because they've never made it before. This isn't just RE4-style. It's complete, down to the simplest things of I'm trying to walk in a circle here, and it's so hard to communicate just from looking at what's happening on the screen. You kind of also need to see my hands, and it doesn't feel good. The kinesthetics of basic movement and shooting does not feel good to play. It doesn't feel
Leon, Helena,
like
come
it
in.
Doesn't have a flow.
If Sarah's intel is on the money, Simmons should be just up ahead. Be
it's
careful.
Not immersive. It doesn't like you're not going to get lost in the game, and that's what you want. Like, that's the entire point. You want the controls of the game to be completely secondary in the player's mind. You don't even want it to enter into the player's mind that they're playing a video game, that they're holding a piece of plastic in their hand and pressing buttons and moving a stick around, because it just feels so natural. And I love having control taken away from me like that. It's so nice! Like, shit like that, just completely ripping you out of the immersion. They're trying to do this radically different gameplay style that they have no experience with. So of course it's not done very well. So of course it's not done very well, because they they don't know how to do it well, because they don't have that, like, 10 to 15 years of refinement of that same basic type of gameplay for years and years and multiple games to really hone the way it controls.
It's for the benefit of the United States and global security.
Can't see how killing the president is good.
So they're trying to do these different kinds of gameplay. And it's gameplay that they have no experience with. That's what I'm trying to say. It doesn't feel fucking good to play this game. This scene is still retarded.
Hold your fire! Those two are still of use to us.
You need to be more careful.
All right. So what's the plan, hero?
Think you can make it to that door? Why don't we just waste...
It's so hard to articulate, too, because so much of the way games kind of hook you, to me, is ephemeral. It's that, like, kind of misty place in between what's happening on the screen and you sitting down and playing. That place in between your hands and the controller. That's where a game, like a really good game, really comes to life and captures you. What? I thought the Jim Joes were working with him.
She got me.
Is Ada working with Simmons?
Well, late.
And totally stabbed his ass in the back.
He's getting away.
Come on.
Maybe that's how she got his ring. That's interesting. Anyway. I'm reminded that Ada Wong exists, so I'm not mad anymore. Okay. Trains are also a really good setting for games that I feel like is inspired a lot. Every time there's a train level in any game, it's always the best part. Even Resident Evil Zero, which is a terrible fucking game. Even terrible, shitty Resident Evil Zero. The train part, like the first hour or so of that game, is fucking fun because it's on a train. Splinter Cell, Pandora, Tomorrow. There's a whole, like, a really fucking famous, memorable sequence where you're on a train in that game, too. Oh, whatever, I don't need this many. In fact, apparently we have a surplus of machine gun ammo, so... Oh. Oh, invisible walls! Invisible walls, you guys. Invisible walls. Okay. Fuck this.
I'm just giving you exactly what you gave me, Simmons. At first, you'll be afraid. But don't worry. You're just becoming the monster you always were. You and everyone else on the planet.
What's with these, like, really gay, like, pseudo-science fiction cell phones where the glass flips out?
Chase me while that woman is on the loose.
Anyway.
What woman? That traitor, Ada Wong. Who knows what she's got in store?
Well, if she's against you, then she can't be all bad.
You're all ours.
Are you here to avenge them?
I don't know. Fucking Ada Wong always kind of plays double agent.
Had he disclosed the truth behind Raccoon City, the U.S. would have lost all its authority, and the global political order would have collapsed.
So to avoid one disaster, you create another? No matter
what are you talking about?
He can't be stopped! He was leading my country and this world into complete...
Shut up.
Chaos.
Although, to be fair, like, Ada also has the most retcons wrapped up around her that make her retarded. Like, I hate in Umbrella Chronicles how fucking Ada, like, there's a level where you play as Ada escaping Raccoon City after the events of Resident Evil 2. because she's all busted up from getting rocked her shit out by the tyrant, by Mr. X. Oh, he's a dog. Okay, whatever. That's gay. That's a really boring design. All of the monsters in this game are really boring. They, you know what they remind me of? They remind me of the Transformers in the Michael Bay Transformers movies. They're like, or instead of being machines, though, they're organic versions.
Keep some distance when we have the chance.
Why? Just shoot them. They look like organic versions of the Transformers, where it's just a complete bungled mishmash of fucking carapace and skin. It just looks really uncreative. Whatever. Can I re- I'm not allowed to reload for some reason. Oh, I guess I'm full. It looks like I'm not though. It looks like there's a second, like, clip indicator underneath the first one for some reason. Whatever.
We need to attack from both sides.
Good job getting in my way then, by the way. Doing a good job. Doing a good job, Helena. Get the fuck out of my way, Helena! Get out of my way, Helena! God damn it! I'ma punch you with my man hands. Where she's escaping Raccoon City. And it's like, aw shit. I gotta get out of here, and she calls up fucking Wesker on the phone. Like, apparently, even as early back in fucking Resident Evil 2, she was working with Wesker. That's fucking stupid. Like, that doesn't make any sense.
Elena, give me a hand.
But that's a retcon in a game who's, like, very questionable canon. And I know the canon of the movie, but like, it's an Ada Wong, so it's important. Why don't you just throw him off the train?
Elena, are you alright?
Why does he get to morph back into a human person, man? He looks like Senator Armstrong, because he's all buff for some reason. He just looks, like, all slashed up. And, oh, look at that. Like, look! Transformers! More than meets the eye! Transformers! Robots in disguise! Autobots in their unlingual to fight the evil Decepticons! I don't know the fucking theme song. My heart. Shut up.
Leon, over here!
Yeah, I'm gonna... Who is that helicopter? Who is this helicopter following us? What? Oh, he just has guns also. Okay. I remember, like, just no rules. Just complete nonsense. I know Resident Evil monsters have never really been much for respecting the conservation of mass, but what the fuck is he shooting at us, and where is it coming from? How is he just naturally producing, like, bone shards, I guess, to shoot at us with his fucking dumb Gatling gun spinal cord? Oh, it's his head. This is so dumb! This monster design is terrible! I'm reminded of this is a weird comparison, but what is this helicopter? What the fuck is going on? Oh, I don't know why that was so amusing. Shut up.
Simmons!
Leon! Simmons! Leon! Ada! Helena! So. Anyway, shit. This is a weird comparison, but I always think of Portal 2. And they have, like, a creator's commentary node talking about designing Wheatley. And, how... look it up. They have this real talk about the design of, like, the orb, but they also needed him to promote with his dialogue, so they had to cheat and have him, like, have eyelids that would open and close, even though technically those eyelids, when they're not open, would just go to nowhere, and they make no sense. And they were like, yeah, we had to cheat, but, you know, it's fine. It's fine. Shut up. I just think of that, like, fucking Valve has this whole fucking commentary note where they're like, we had to, like, make it make sense. And then you get to this game, and it's just fucking retarded. And I hate it. It's stupid. I don't care. This is dumb. Oh god. Helena, you suck. Because you're trying to be Claire Redfield. She's trying to be Claire Redfield. And this offends me. On a deep moral level, it offends me that she's trying to be Claire Redfield. You can so obviously tell. And fuck you, you're not Claire Redfield. I hate you. You're just awful. She's so awful. Anyway, I guess. Echo team to HQ. Oh, slow walking. Slow walking the video game. Oh, let's rip control of the camera away and show the thing. Because look. Fuck off.
Let's go. Game.
Okay, how would the president revealing the secret behind Raccoon City have done anything to the country? I mean, like, I would think the fact that they just nuked an American city for no reason would be way more of a like, what the fuck is wrong with you, United States? You literally nuked your own fucking country for no reason. And they're like, what did they say? Like, what did they say? Oh, there was a thing. I don't know, we just had to do it. Shut up. Oh, I'm gonna tell the truth about Raccoon City. There were zombies. No! That will take away the United States credibility. But bioterrorism is like a global occurrence now. Remember Terra Grigia? Shut up. Remember Terra Grigia, you guys? And it's just fucking really stupid. Like, how would exposing the truth behind the Raccoon City incident do anything? I don't...
The one she gave us.
Oh, hey, my phone and the microchip still works, even though we were dunked into the fucking ocean.
Jake. Hunnigan.
I like phones that and little data chips that magically work even after being submerged in your fucking pocket in the water for like 10 minutes. Oh shit, they're gonna nuke the city.
Chris Redfield.
Chris Redfield.
We're just outside of Tachi. Why?
Get the hell out of there!
Chris Redfield, dun dun dun. Why is that a surprise? Oh, that's fucking gay. Oh, it's a C-virus bomb, I get it. Okay, I was like, they're nuking the city again? What? But no, it's a virus bomb. That's actually kind of awesome. That's actually kind of sick awesome. And like, it's all foggy. Oh, that's really cool. Again, I love the inconsistency of the C virus. randomly either turning people into Jim Joes or turning them into zombies. Wait a minute. Leon still hasn't fought any Jim Joes. He didn't fight any Jim Joes this entire chapter. Holy shit. He fought the slug monster, he fought the Udacek, and he fought Simmons. He hasn't fought any Jim Joes. That's super interesting. Leon doesn't fight any Jim Joes. That's nifty. Anyway. Again, I love the fucking C-Virus being able to just do whatever the fuck it wants. If you inject it, it turns you into a Jim Joe. But if it's a gas, then it turns you into a zombie. If you inhale it, it turns you into a zombie, I guess. Okay, I guess we gotta do this, I guess. I guess.